Hi guys, so welcome again to our new video. So before guys, tayo mag-proceed sa new topic natin, which is integration by parts. So let's try to solve this problem. So actually, parang extension lang to ng problem natin about inverse like function. Okay? So our function, or should I say our fifth problem, is the integral of quantity 4x minus 7 dx over x squared minus 6x plus 13. So, dito, so if you're going to notice, we cannot readily substitute u. Ito na type ng substitution dito. Kasi u is equals to x squared minus 6x plus 13. Since wala siyang easy substitution, hindi mo rin ang pwedeng i-distribute dx agad, tsaka yung integral sign. So, dito, may gamit tayo ng konting technique or magic dito, guys. So, what should we do? So, pwedeng ito gawin natin. So, let's divide this or break down natin to into two components. So, gawin natin siya integral of quantity 4x minus 12 plus 7 dx over x squared minus 6x plus 13. So, yun. So, diba? Of course, negative 12 plus 7, plus 5, sorry. 5 pala, 5 di 7. 5. Yeah. So, of course, negative 12 plus 5 is negative 7, diba? Then, isa-isolate natin to. So, gawin natin integral of 4x minus 12 plus 5. So, gawin natin ang bracket dx over x squared minus 6x plus 13. Then we can now distribute. So distribute natin yung integral sign tsaka yung dx. So gawin natin integral of 4. Then we factor out 4. So may iwan sa loob x minus 3 dx over x squared minus 6x plus 13 plus 5 integral of dx over x squared minus 6x plus 13. Okay na. Naintindihan guys. So, after factoring, so ito, in-isolate natin 4x minus 12 plus 5. Distribute natin. Then, we factor out 4. So, x minus 3 dx. So, dito, kung mapansin natin, if we let dito sa first, ano natin, expression nitong part na to. If you let u, x squared minus 6x plus 13, and we take the derivative, so du is 2x minus 6x, then derivative of x, ay sorry, 6 pala, derivative of x as dx, and we factor out 2, so magiging x minus 3 dx. Dito, if we factor out 2, diba? So may 2, integral of, may iwan sa loob, 2 na lang, x minus 3 dx over x squared minus 6x plus 13. Plus, dito, ang gawin natin dito sa second expression natin. So we complete the squares. So how do we do that? So 5, integral of dx. So, completing the square, so x squared minus 6x. So, complete the square, so yung c is b over 2 squared. So, yung b natin yung 6. So, 6 divided by 2, 3 plus squared. So, squared, 3 squared is 9. Then, kung ano yung dinagdag dito, subtract mo ngayon dito. So, 13 minus 4, minus 3 is, ilan? 9 pala, sorry, not 4. 13 minus 9. So, yun na. So, dito, we can replace this by u. Yung 2x minus 3dx. So, pwede natin palitan ng du. Then, yung sa baba, yun na siya. So, ln na yan. Plus 5 integral of dx over. So, dito, perfect square na siya, di ba? So, that is x minus 3 squared plus 9. 13 minus 9 is 4. And kung mapansin natin to guys, is already arctangent, di ba? Where a squared is equals to 4, a is equals to 2. Pag kinuha niyo yung square ng both sides, and yung u natin is x minus 3. And du is equals to dx. Okay na. So, this becomes, of course, this one is, integral niyan is 2 ln of u plus, of course, 1 over, yung a natin, 2. Times 5 pa pala. So, may 5 pa dito. So, times 5. So, inverse tangent of x minus 3 over 2 plus c. And ibalik natin yung u dito, which is ito. Diba, ito yung u nito dito sa part na to. So, it becomes 2 ln of x squared minus 6x plus 13 plus 5 over 2 arctangent of x minus 3 over 2 plus c. And this will be our final answer. Okay, so dito guys, so combination na siya ng techniques. So dapat dito we gumamit tayo ng konting magic. So in-inverse natin. So we let negative 7 as a sum of negative 12 plus 5. Then we isolate for x minus 12 plus 5. So in-isolate natin to. Then we distribute the integral sign and the factor out for. So, may 1 for x minus 3 all over x squared minus 6 plus 13 plus 5 integral of dx over x squared minus 6 plus 13. Then, dito let yun na lang. So, konting manipulation. So, ln na to. Then, ito, we complete the squares. Then, napansin natin, it's already an inverse tangent or arctangent. So, ayun na. So, simple integration. Then, we arrive at the final answer, guys. Okay, so, ano naman, dagdag extension or it's extended problem lang naman. So, about inverse tangent and or inverse type of functions. Okay, so let's proceed to our lecture, which is integration by parts. So, ayun na. So, ito guys, ginagamit to. So, this one has a form of, ito yung equation niya. Integral of u dv is equals to uv minus integral of v du. So, ito yung general formula ito. Itong part na to, guys. Yan. So, integral of u dv is equals to uv minus v du. So, una ako na kayo guys dito. Sa please careful with the examples natin. So, tingnan nyo kasi dito, nag-i-integrate tayo. Tapos, nag-derivative din. Halos sabay na sabay yung dalawa. So, later makikita nyo by yung procedures pala natin when we solve the following examples. Okay? The next video natin. Okay. So, as a definition of integration by parts. So, this method of integration is specifically helpful when the integrand is the product of two kinds of functions. So, integrand na nito. Nasa loob ng integral sign. So, dalawa yung function natin. So, I have here at least the four basic types ng function na makikita nyo na pwedeng gamitan ng integration by parts. So, una, eto. So, meron tayong algebraic tsaka exponential function. So, combination niya, sabihin niya ng algebraic and exponential function. So, integral of x, which is yung x mo dito, guys, yun yung algebraic function. And yung e to the x, yung exponential. So, yung combination yan, dx. So, dito, integration by parts yan. Since you have two functions na naka-product. So, number two. So, another kinds na pwedeng makuha natin. Or type of functions na pwede sa integration by parts is combination naman ng algebraic tsaka trigonometric. So, ito naman, x squared sine x dx. Of course, yung x squared, yun yung algebraic for part or algebraic function. While yung sine x naman, yung trigonometric. Then, number 3. So, combination naman ng exponential tsaka trigonometric. So, yan. E to the x cosine x dx. Yung e to the x, of course, yun yung exponential. and cosine x yung trigonometric. Then lastly, so algebraic tsaka logarithmic naman. So dito, integral of x, which is yung algebraic expression or function, and yung ln of x dx as yung logarithmic naman na function. So yun yung four parang common type ng combination ng function na makikita natin sa integration by parts. So sabi ko nga guys, sa next video natin we'll be solving examples and sabay na rin dun yung procedures. So tuturo ko step by step on how to perform integration by parts, guys. So we watch out for our next video. Thank you, guys.